Good afternoon, Fort Atkinson High School. Please join me in standing for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for the announcements. Just a reminder that Monday, November 16th is an early release day at 1:30 p.m. There will be no enrichment or support in the afternoon, so please keep that in mind as you plan for your week ahead. Picture retake day has been rescheduled again for Tuesday, December 1st from 8 a.m. until 1:30 p.m. in the high school auditorium. This may change due to current circumstances, so please make sure you keep checking the high school website for updated information. Additionally, we post all of our announcements under the FAHS Communication tab on the website. Any information that you might have missed is posted for your viewing. Winter sports will be starting the week of November 16th and November 23rd. If you're interested in participating in a sport this winter season, please make sure to reach out to Mrs. Kane at kohnk@fortschools.org. Girls basketball will be starting on Monday, November 16th. Boys basketball, boys swim, and wrestling will be starting on Monday, November 23rd. For additional information about FAHS Athletics, visit our website at www.fortathletics.com. Suppose you missed the first ever virtual activity fair on Wednesday during enrichment. In that case, we welcome students to visit our Google site page to explore the different options available at Fort Atkinson High School. We offer a wide variety of clubs and organizations to fit the needs of our unique students. Seniors, if you missed Jostens' graduation informational email sent out yesterday, please visit jostens.com to order any graduation materials your family wishes to purchase. Jostens offers a wide variety of graduation packages, senior apparel, caps and gowns, and more. Make sure to visit jostens.com for more information. Another one for seniors, the Herb Cole Educational Foundation will once again be offering $5,000 Cole Excellence Scholarships to graduating students who intend to enroll at a 2 or 4 year college or university. This is a very competitive scholarship based on a student's academic achievements as well as diverse extracurricular involvement. The online application for the Cole Excellence Scholarship is available at coleeducation.org. The deadline for applications is Tuesday, November 17th. This scholarship does require 3 letters of recommendation, so you're advised to start working on it early. Juniors and seniors, the monthly newsletter for November has been posted on the Fort Atkinson High School website under the Pupil Services link. Each month, the Pupil Services staff prepares a monthly newsletter of activities, scholarships, and opportunities to attend workshops, college visits, camps, and conferences. It also includes a listing of local job opportunities. Make sure to visit our website and click on the Pupil Services page for more information. Are you a dedicated artist and want to join a group of other dedicated artists? Would you like to get connected with great art opportunities? How about being interested in supporting our community by providing art for others to enjoy? Well, if you are an active art student that has a passion for the arts and have taken 2 or more classes, or are a freshman who signed up for 2 classes, and are willing to participate in virtual events on weekends or evenings, you should consider applying for the National Art Honor Society. If you're interested, feel free to contact Mrs. Zabel or Mr. Korb in the art department, or use the link that pops up here to apply to join. I already let everyone know who our winners were last week for our comfy dress-up day, along with our trivia contest winners. I hope everyone got a chance to check out the winners from this week's Secret Agent or Patriotic Dress-Up Day, which should be coming out soon. Hopefully you got a chance to check out our email for upcoming event for our virtual Spirit Month coming with our upcoming virtual talent show. It's on social media too, but additional details were provided in that email. If you're interested in competing for multiple prizes from our vault while showing off your awesome talent, check your email, follow the directions included, and get signed up. Please note, if we don't have enough interested people sign up, we may postpone it until later in the school year. Also, next Wednesday will be our next dress-up day with Class Color Day. Freshmen will be yellow, sophomores will be blue, juniors red, and seniors pink. Staff will be green for that day. Show your spirit and make sure to wear your class colors next Wednesday. Submit your pick to highschool@fortschool.org or the bit.ly address that has been shared out and be entered to win prizes again. And now how about some spotlights? Let's start with our student spotlight again this week. This student was recommended for always working hard and always having a positive attitude. He's also really good at English and shows a passion for learning, which is awesome to see. This week's spotlighted student is Hunter Rogers. Congrats, Hunter, on your well-earned spotlight, and keep up the great work. And now for our teacher spotlight. One of our students sent in that, I think this teacher is doing an amazing job. They have 3+ classes that they have to take care of all the time and does it so well. They stay after school every day to make YouTube videos for our classes when they could be at home. They have so much work to do and still manage to balance their home life and school life while teaching all day. They still even make time for us one-on-one. Another student adds, this teacher has been doing the most since the first day of quarantine last school year. From the start, they tried their hardest to communicate effectively, adjust assignments to better suit online learning, and show genuine care for every single student they have. They made sure that I didn't feel disconnected during the rocky final weeks of last year. They've been working as hard every virtual day since then. They check in on every student individually, they genuinely care about how I am doing, and they're always open to input from their classes on how to teach online better. They also went on to say 11 out of 10 would give her 5 stars on Yelp. This week's spotlighted teacher is Mrs. Zabel in our art department. Congratulations, Mrs. Zabel. It's a well-deserved honor.
I've been using Google Classroom for I don't know how many years, probably 4 or 5 years, but not at the level that's necessary for our current situation. So I've been using a lot more of Google Classroom to post weekly plans so my students can always see what we're doing, what they need to do, have all the links in one place. And all my students are now turning their work in digitally as opposed to physically. So that's a shift that we have made as well, which I think is good in the long run. They're learning to take pictures of their work and post those and get those out into the world. We're obviously using Zoom to do critiques and sharing things that way. We've used Flipgrids to do critiques. So just trying to reimagine how we're interacting with each other, but still making sure we interact, because I think it's a really important part of what we do in an art classroom. I don't want them to come into the room, exist as this like solo entity, and then leave with no interactions with their peers or with me. So really trying to think of new ways to start conversations and continue conversations about their art and life through Zoom. That's really important to me that they're making those connections. I try to think beyond, you know, art. I'm an art teacher, I obviously want my kids to grow as artists, but who they are as people is the most important to me and how they're doing as people. And I know this is a really hard time for everybody, especially as we're going into winter. I think we're all looking at this winter with a little fear in our eyes, right? Like it's gonna be kind of long. And so I think in an art classroom, we have unique opportunities to connect to each other. And we need to have those connections outside our households, especially right now. So just conversations about life and how we're doing and, you know, caring for each other and laughing together and all those things we would normally do in a classroom atmosphere that's a little bit harder to do in Zoom, just working hard to make sure that happens. I'm liking that my kids are getting more comfortable as the year goes on with like having their cameras on, talking and having conversations about their art, about how things are going in front of each other. They're not as anxious about that. So I'm liking that shift. I think we've made some good shifts with what we're doing, or I made some good shifts with what I'm doing instructionally. I'm making a lot of demo videos and posting those to YouTube for all of my assignments. And I'm liking how those are working. I think they're going to be great tools in the long run, because if I have a student that misses a demo, they can always pull up that video, watch it. If they are confused about something that I've taught them, they can go back and reference that as well. So I'm liking some of the tools that I'm building, both for the moment, but how they're also going to function in the long run. I think the best advice that I've ever been given in my life has just been what I've observed other people doing. So watching my high school art teacher, Miss Luck, who is this amazing woman, treat every single kid as if they matter, because they do. And making sure that every single one of us in her classroom knew that she cared for us and she valued us and the work that we did made all the difference in how kids interacted in that room and how they felt. And so I try to bring that into my teaching, because every single kid in my classroom does matter. And I do care about them and their work that they do, and I want to help them grow and feel comfortable and confident in who they are. I love teaching art. I love my art students, and I can't imagine doing anything else. They're amazing. I'm so thankful for my students going on this journey with me and having faith that we'd get somewhere good with our art despite not being together, because it's, they know, I know, this isn't the easiest class to transition to online. And you know, we're missing some things I can't replicate. I can't replicate the moments in class where I go around one-on-one and really dig into what a kid's doing. And I can get close to it online, but not the same. And I'm just really thankful that my students have had the faith in me that we'd get where we needed to go, and had patience, and have worked really hard along with me to try to do the best they can at home, because it's hard. They're rock stars. I love them.
Big thanks to all of you that have sent in spotlights, student and staff alike. Keep them coming in. If you didn't get the student or teacher spotlighted in here this week, don't worry. We'll get to everyone in the announcements over time. Be patient and keep watching the announcements for your spotlighted Blackhawk. Happy birthday this week is going out to Emma Yan, Gregory Bartholness, Mitchell Broadhead, Jacob Schradel, Gavin Taylor, Mason Brandel, Gavin Waltney, Emma Mitchell, Ryan Acosta, Callum Fettig, Reagan Horwath, Christian Wege, Michaela Wege, Alora Colson, Kaylin Haug, Hannah Marquardt, Krista Ammons, Chloe Socha. November 9th through November 15th for all of you. Happy birthday. I hope it's a great one. And now for some words of wisdom. Have you ever heard this Hebrew proverb? Where there is no vision, the people will perish. That's an interesting thing to think about. What's your vision for tomorrow? What dreams are you dreaming? How do you see the world changing ahead of you? Goethe, Germany's most famous writer and one of the world's greatest literary geniuses, said, "Whatever you can do or dream, you can begin it. Boldness has genius, power, and magic in it." Anybody out there without a vision? It's easy to do and to lose sight of the future and remain positive when we are constantly bombarded with so much negativity. But no vision? Perish that thought and keep dreaming and looking to your future. With something to think about, this is Mr. Halverson. Make it a great day or not, the choice is yours. Thanks for listening to the announcements, everybody, and I look forward to seeing you again next week.